space. So it's almost up. So the topic that we're going to do today is radiation. Now it's cloudy. It's quite cloudy and windy today. Let me add to that. But yes, whenever you see the sun, it's quite upright right now. The topic we're going to do today is radiation and its effect on different surfaces. The technique that I recently learned is associative technique based on experiment, and we're going to try it today in the class. What do I want you to do is first just shake hands with each other. Can you find a partner to shake hands? How did you feel? Did you feel somebody's hand hot?
No.
And cold? Maybe somebody's even sweaty? Yes? So there's this different you could feel. And people who are sitting next to the wall, can you just touch the wall? And if you can touch the non-tile surface. Did you feel any difference?
Yes.
Slight difference? So in the break, I want you to do something. That go outside where you're having your lunch. Or after finishing your lunch, if you can just touch different surfaces, touch the outside which is plaster, ones which is not plaster, this wonderful bench that we've created just outside the tree shade, the granite, do you all recognize? Just outside the gate. Just touch that and just try and understand how cooler or hotter certain surface feels. Okay? So, the reason because this difference is occurring is because number one, there is a difference in the solar radiation or the sunlight, sun heat falling on it. Number two is the innate property of itself, of the material, which is causing this difference to happen. Some material is absorbing more heat, some is reflecting more. Okay? Now cut to, I will be showing the animation like a revision from semester 1 where the sun is there and the earth is revolving. I usually show that. It's similar to one they had shown, but they had a simulation one, but I use a YouTube one. So I will do that. Continuing from again, talk about the revision about the conduction, convection and radiation from the first semester, just to continue. And next I will. Now, can you give me example of some interesting buildings that you visited?
Any Indian Habitat Center.
Indian Habitat Center. Very nice.
Nice.
Anyone else? IIC. Any historic example maybe? Something, I mean we all have visited.
Humayun's
tomb.
Taj
Mahal. How did you feel in IIC, IIC? I used to Taj Mahal when you went inside. Okay, great, but I would not expect a second semester student to come with that term. But it's fine, it's absolutely fine.
Place like
Kathmandu
City.
Yes.
What happens is, first, it's extremely hot. It's very difficult to walk with my bare foot. They don't allow you to
get inside. Perfect.
Because the floor is extremely hot, but when I'm inside any structure, it's very there's no air change, but it feels very nice.
Good. So when we are walking, especially in historical monuments where you're not allowed to take your shoes inside, you kind of try to walk in the shaded area, isn't it? The ones which are shaded either by the parapet or the monument itself, and not walk from the granite or marble directly. Even the marble of Taj Mahal, if you go in the scorching heat, not as cool as, so you see most of the crowd is either towards that shaded part, and there's this big chunk of area which where nobody is using that area, and then maybe towards the boundary where again the shading is happening. So what is the phenomena that's causing it? Is again based on the amount of heat that particular material is absorbing.
Ma'am, I visited a huge glass building in Mumbai. Indian Bulls building. So like, so but I feel very different when I visited in the Habitat Center.
So you felt very different,
yeah.
In the Indian Habitat Center. What time did you visit it?
Around 5 p.m.
So the sun was setting. Okay, to come to that, let's do one more thing. let's take a quick round in our own corridor and try and figure out where are we feeling the hot most. So, experiment happening. We are all going there. We are in the faculty corridor, which is. Can you guess the direction of the faculty corridor? If I put a compass on the top of our resource room, what direction would it be? Our faculty corridor.
West.
This corridor, the one that we use for this room, 109. This is the faculty corridor.
This is the east.
The it's kind of north east.
Corridor. Then it gives me north and facing, you know, outside. Then we are facing towards
southwest.
Mostly
towards west, but yeah. Southwest. Yes. Is everybody able to figure out that direction? Okay, great. So when we do that, we will see, because currently the sun is in the south, we are around noon, lot of heat is being absorbed by the neighboring building. And whatever is cutting through, we are only getting in certain parts of the courtyard. Similarly, when Matao visited Habitat Center yesterday at evening 5 p.m., she was only able to feel heat only in certain parts which was not cut down by the neighboring building.
Ma'am, I didn't get it. What happened? I didn't get that point. Please explain it again.
Okay, so I am saying the radiation, the sun, light and heat was only falling on certain parts in a certain direction. Only in the west direction, southwest direction at 5 p.m. And maybe you did not face the direct radiation at that time.
Okay.
And then, okay. The PPT lecture is happening now. So I am doing all the topics in the lecture. After the lecture, I introduce the students to the climatology lab instrument we have, an infrared gun. And